Legacy Infinity's AI. We're going to study the historical battles in hopes of increasing your tactical skills for the future. As a bonus, it's a pretty fun game you can play in your spare time. So let's get to it. Loading up records for the Battle of Dratheus V. The fighting started when a splinter sect of Covenant ignored the ceasefire of 2552 and attacked UNSC forces. By the time the fighting was done, well, it didn't end well for the UNSC or the Covenant, either one. Spartans Davis and Palmer were both stationed on Dratheus V's moon at the time of the first attack. Let's see how they succeeded in repelling the first assault waves.
Thank you. Thank you.
Spartan Davis continued fighting on the moon, Spartan Palmer and a handful of UNSC troops redeployed to the surface of Dratheus V to fend off the invaders there. Outmanned? Outgunned? Spartan Palmer didn't see it as a problem. How about you?
Coming! Thank you.
Even though the battle was going in the Spartans' favor, Dratheus V had a surprise in store. Its moon wasn't a moon at all. It was a forerunner creation designed to build and destroy entire planets. Nobody knew about this until the Covenant cult leader found a way to reactivate the old forerunner tech and start disassembling Dratheus V. It was Spartan Davis's job to shut down the device.
Yeah. Objective successful. We're about to have guests.
Oh.
Almost done.
Davis deactivated the device. Dratheus V wasn't quite the safe and secure planet it used to be. Suddenly, Spartan Palmer wasn't just fighting off hordes of Covenant. She was heading an evacuation. With so many UNSC craft destroyed by the initial attack, she needed to find an alternate way to get everyone off world.
Thank you.
Gravis sacrificed himself to save many lives on Dratheus V. Although the Covenant forces were broken, the UNSC command wanted the Covenant leader, Murg Vol, eliminated. Spartan Palmer was tasked with returning to the moon to finish the job.
Thank you.
Halfway there.
Lord.